The COVID-19 Medical Task Force is recounting the horrific days they went through when the country was engulfed by the pandemic. Maria Nantai, a nursing officer at Mulago Hospital, recounts the 2 years she's worked in the high-dependency COVID-19 unit as the most horrible days in her career.
Past 5 months, people have not been paid their salaries. NSSF was last paid in November, and the team that was deployed from Mwalimu and later taken on by Ministry of Health has never received pay since they received their contract from Ministry of Health. It's so absurd to bring to you the notice that as nurses, we took a very good step in taking care of the COVID patients. We worked like 24/7. However much we had shifts, I remember there is a day when I was burnt by the PPE. People got out when their eyes couldn't see anymore. The goggles could burn your faces, the masks, because of the long hours. You couldn't leave a patient who was dying because your shift is ending. So we had to sacrifice and carry on.
These health workers, however, got the shock of their life after the Ministry of Health decided to terminate their contracts with immediate effect instead of retaining them as earlier promised by President Museveni. They also claim they haven't received their allowances for the past 6 months.
The holistic nurses, nursing care that nurses render to these patients, you can even cry when you look at that letter of termination. We carried people's buckets, having their poo-poo and urine every day. We changed their diapers. Changing a diaper of a 70-year-old, you know the smell, it's not pleasant at all. And then we had to feed them, because most of them couldn't feed. Our backs broke.
Thank the permanent secretary and Minister of Health for rewarding our teams that have worked tirelessly for the last 2 years and have managed COVID comparatively better in the region, in the continent, and globally. The team that sacrificed their families, the team that lost some of their colleagues, you forwarding them with the termination of 2 days' notice. Thank you very much, our permanent secretary.
Uganda Medical Association President Dr. Samuel Oledo says they are disappointed after government's failure to fulfill a promise it made.
Perturbed when presidential directives are not honored by individuals we think understand health the most. As Uganda Medical Association, because of the presidential directives last year, which were very instrumental. One of them was deploy doctors even up to health center. 3, deploy nurses. We would expect this policy paper to be presented to parliament. That because we have a 60% gap in staffing, we would have these numbers coming in place. These COVID specialists you're seeing behind me are some of the few 1,000 medical workers who are employed. Who is failing the fountain of honor when it comes to service delivery?
The health workers have further vowed to seek legal remedies.
The medical association, these things, among others, sicken the entire medical profession. As Uganda Medical Association, we had asked that because of the great engagements we've had with government and the great efforts government has showed up, we would push industrial action to indefinite. However, doctors had agreed that 1st of May, when nothing is put in the budget framework, industrial action shall be reinstated or reactivated. By the look of things, by the frustrations going on in health, it is clear indication that what we intended not to implement, we might bring it a little closer.
In November last year, all COVID-19 medical staff across the country were validated and were awaiting appointment letters. With the termination, over 3,000 health workers will be affected. This report was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.